All right, we're going to take a quick look today at one of the things that produces a lot of the modulation on your brakes, which is the lever that is incorporated on the design or the lever that you've put on the brakes. So the basics of that, this is a two-finger MT5 lever. They call it two-finger, but the reality is you're still going to just use the one finger. You just move it further inboard. This is a single finger. This is the HC MT5 lever. You can see when we put the pivot points up next to each other, this is a longer lever. That means there's more distance to travel to engage the master cylinder. So this longer lever is actually going to provide slightly more modulation because the power is going to come on slightly slower versus the shorter HC lever, which is going to snap the power on just a little bit quicker. Now that's based on the leverage ratio advantage from the pivot point to the input on the master cylinder to your contact point. So as we bring this closer to the input, the movement becomes closer to 1-to-1. So here I'd barely have to move it at all, and it would be hard to control. When I've got my finger out here, I've got a nice level of control over that. Now with the Magura MT7 lineup, there's a one finger, two finger. This is actually my favorite brake lever right here. And then there's the HC3 lever, which we're going to get into, which kind of gives you the best of both worlds in a lot of ways. Now, what makes the HC3 lever interesting is it's able to change this leverage ratio. Now, everybody's seen the throw adjust, which is how far out your lever sticks, and that's what this does. So by pulling this contact point in or out, I'm drawing the lever in or out, and then it still has to do the same amount of throw. With the HC3 lever, what riders are able to do is to get a singular lever that allows fine-tuning of both the fit on the throw as well as the distance or the leverage ratio on the input. It's controlled with the torque wrench, and as you adjust this, that input moves in or out depending on which direction you're adjusting it. If you're moving it closer to your finger, you're slightly lowering the mechanical advantage, so it's going to have more power. The power is going to come on quicker. If you'd like to have a little bit more modulation in your brake, in that case you go ahead and you increase the distance. And that's going to give you kind of the equivalent of a two-finger lever. And also you've got everything in between. But that's how modulation is done with these systems. And that's why the Magura brakes are very popular, is because you're able to get so much personality with simply adjusting the levers or choosing the lever that you like.